breaking Rand Paul inflicted with life-threatening injuries, trouble breathing, media does not care. Rand Paul is a badass. He's evaded death twice this year from the clutches of liberal psychopaths, the first during the congressional baseball shooting in June, and now after a Sanders-supporting lunatic beat him nearly to death in his own front yard. You heard right, he was beaten nearly to death. We're not exaggerating. The mainstream media has done another brilliant job at ignoring and downplaying the severity of the assault on Paul and how close this could have come to a historical political disaster, reporting only minor injuries. The LA Times reports that the assault on his lawn in Bowling Green left the Republican senator with 5 broken ribs and gashes in his mouth and nose when the left-wing extremist tackled him. What's more alarming is that the attack also left Paul with labored breathing. Doug Stafford, a senior advisor to Paul, reported that the senator was in considerable pain and could barely move around or even fly on a plane. Doctors confirmed even worse news: of the 5 broken ribs, 3 were displaced fractures, which can be life-threatening, and Paul's pain could last for weeks or months. That is not a minor injury. If that doesn't make your blood boil, listen to this. Renee Albert Boucher, 59, a registered Democrat who obsessively posted pro-Bernie Sanders and anti-Trump rants on his Facebook, was arrested and was only charged with 4th-degree assault and has been released Saturday night on a $7,500 bond, the LA Times reports. Our justice system is a complete joke. For sustaining life-threatening injuries on a high-profile politician, this man should be in jail for the next decade. Letting this bloodthirsty nut out on the streets is not just insane, it's sure to inspire other left-wing scumbags when they realize the politically correct courts are rigged in their favor. Here's the kicker: Boucher is Paul's neighbor. Poor Rand Paul isn't going to be mowing his lawn or sleeping easy at night with that thug living next door. And who paid for that loser's bail, anyways? An Obama deep state agent, no doubt. We know why the media only begrudgingly and minimally reports on these instances, because whenever a lone wolf liberal tries to pull off another John Wilkes Booth on a Republican leader, it flies straight in the face of their hypnotic narrative of liberal peaceful, conservative violent. Go ahead and do a Google search, you can't even find results for violent Trump supporters, or Democrat politician assaulted. Not even the super liberal search engine can dig up results against our case.